Professionals, and a lot of people will never know what they do. Sergeant Joel David Clarkson died serving with an elite group of soldiers as an Army Ranger. The Fairbanks native died of injuries sustained during a patrol in Afghanistan in March of 2010. Today, a training building on post was dedicated to him. Lacey Grosvold has more.
If I had only one thing that I could say to describe him, it would be something that he said. It says, some people ask if it was hard being born a legend. I say no.
He was very passionate, energetic. Just always there for you if you needed anything. He'd be right there, drop of the hat. He always led out. He always wanted to lead out.
His mother says Joel would have wanted to share this honor with the men he served with.
We just figured that being how this happened, he had to be involved in some, pretty heavy things.
Joel first considered the military at age 8, playing in the woods behind the family's home off Chena Hot Springs Road.
Joel was a man of passion. He passionately loved and he passionately hated, and that was the way he was from a small child.
Joel applied this self-assured, intense approach to everything in his life. When Joel was back from his first deployment, he met Cassandra at a bonfire. He told her there that he was going to marry her.
I knew he was serious. I knew, and that's what scared me.
They married about 4 years later. His son Orion was just 3 months when Joel left for his fifth and final deployment. Karen and Cassandra say the resemblance between father and son is uncanny.
He walks like him. He pouts like him. I mean, certainly Orion's his own person, and I certainly see his mommy in there too.
I see a lot of him in Orion. It blows, it kind of makes you want to believe. Like, if you don't believe in ghosts or spirits or whatever, for those non-believers, it kind of makes you think twice about it because Orion's mannerisms.
The past 2 years have been tough for Cassandra. She's pushed through, raising a baby, going to college, working. She says her close relationship with her in-laws has been vital. She's also got the support from Joel's former Ranger buddies.
I had all the guys that were really close with Orion write Orion letters about, their favorite memory of his father. And there will never be a day he won't know who he is. No amount of stories or, home videos or pictures is going to, amount to actually knowing Joel personally. But it's the only thing we have, and it's the best we can do.
Karen and Cassandra have no doubt how Joel would have felt to have a building named after him.
His name has been set in stone in so many states and places. His memory's never going to die. And I know he's up there going, yeah.
For News 13, I'm Lacey Grosvold.